Hello everyone, welcome to Space Tarot. Today I wanted to show you this deck I've just got, which is a brand new deck, not only for me and my collection, obviously, but like for the rest of the world, because it was released like a couple of months ago, I believe. So, I mean, not many people know about its existence. And it's been a while since my last review, so here we are. And this is called Tarot de Carlotides. I don't know how to pronounce that, Carlotides, Carlotides, but anyway, this is by a very young and talented Spanish illustrator called Carlota Santos. It's a deck that was designed for Fournier, and it has the same size as, you know, other Fournier tarot decks. Here I have Tarot del Fuego, so you can see that the size is, you know, exactly the same, and the feeling you get as you hold the box in your hands is exactly the same one. I mean, it's, you know, as far as that is concerned, is your typical Fournier tarot deck. And well, that being said, let's open the box, shall we? And here the first thing you notice is the inside, or at least that was what I noticed as soon as I removed the cellophane and I opened it. You know, that design, that very sophisticated design it has, which, you know, matches this Marie Antoinette, I don't know, that's the name that came to mind when I saw this. It matches that. It's very girly, feminine, and sophisticated. Yeah, those are the vibes I get from this deck. Here we have the leaflet, which is, you know, if you already know about tarot, I mean, there's nothing really useful here because it's pretty basic, as you can see. But if you are new to tarot, so this could actually be, you know, pretty helpful. And we are not even going to talk that much about this leaflet. Let's leave it over here with the box. And I mean, just take a look at the back of the cards. Really beautiful. And of course, it matches, you know, the inside of the box, which I like a lot. It's a pretty nice detail. Here we have the extra cards. This is one of them. So I have already opened this. Have the other one. Where is the other one? We have always two extra cards. I believe that it's okay, it's in here, it's inside the box. We always have two extra cards, you know, in which you have the name of the deck itself, and then we have here dibujos originales. This is like original drawings by Carlota Santos, and you have the who made the deck, basically. So let's leave that over there. And now let's see the cards, shall we? Which is, you know, the whole reason about me making this video. Now let me put them in here. I think that's the right place. So you can see the cards as I show them to you. And here we have the Fool, which is, you know, the one who starts the tarot journey, of course. You see? I'm going to get it a little bit closer so you can see the details in it. It's half naked, almost naked. So it's like, to me, emphasizes the whole idea about impulsiveness, you know. Here we have what I call David Bowie. He's the magician. I'm a huge Bowie fan, so I really loved that that way in which this card was represented. You see? That has to be David Bowie. Here we have the High Priestess. See? Then we have the Empress, which I see as a bride. So if I'm doing a reading and this card shows up, I will be like, okay, somebody's getting married. Because, I mean, look at how she's dressed. I mean, that white dress. Then we have the Emperor. Very rebellious emperor who is so much in control that he doesn't care how he's dressed, you know, just look at him. So it really emphasizes the whole idea about being in control. That's my opinion, of course. Here we have Sumo Sacerdote, the Hierophant. He looks pretty chill, doesn't he? He's even, you know, having this it's like having dinner with a rabbit, so it to me it adds an element of fantasy in here, which is not typical for the Hierophant, because, you know, the Hierophant is very much about the rules and what you're supposed to be doing and getting real, which again I like because it can add a different perspective to a reading. Then we have the Lovers. They are already together in here and not separated. So again, that's a completely different, it could be a completely different interpretation. Then we have the Chariot, Marie Antoinette, again in here. And that's who I see in there. You know, not only victorious, but elegant and sophisticated. I like that. Then we have Justice. The Hermit, a very flamboyant hermit, if you ask me, which I like. But still, it has the original meaning. He's all by himself, you know, holding his, what I like to call, his inner light. Then we have the Wheel of Fortune. Then we have the Strength card, which I see flexibility in here. I mean, right off the bat, be flexible, or, you know, represent same flexibility as an inner strength. That's how I will see it. Then we have the Hangman. Death. I think about Mexico and, you know, the Catrinas. That's what I see with this card. I like it. It makes that card a little bit more colorful. Which can show that endings don't have to be that bad, right? Then we have Temperance. Interesting, you see? She has like a transparent dress and she's like a part of the picture. Interesting. Again, that can give you a complete different interpretation. Then we have the Devil. Two lovers who are chained to one another, so you know the representation is more or less the same. The Tower, yeah, we get that, you know, tragedy vibe in there, but with a dragon in this case, which I like. I love dragons. Then we have the Star. The Elegant. The Moon. Sophisticated. I don't sense that confusion that comes with the Moon card, you know, that thing about you looking at the reflection and not knowing what you're looking at and being confused. I don't get that feeling from this card. So again, that adds more to, you know, the reading with this deck. Then we have the Sun. I thought about the Queen of Wands as I saw this card. We don't have any children in here, so again, the interpretation can be a little bit different. Then we have Judgment. We have that, you know, that idea about resurrection in here with those skeletons, or at least that's how I see it. And the World, which is very typical, you know, but it has its touch, you know. And here we have the Four. Fixed signs, and yeah, we get that idea about a cycle coming to an end. Now, okay, we're done with the major arcana. Now let's take a look at the minor arcana, shall we? See, so here we have Ace of Pentacles. Two of Pentacles. More than juggling the pentacles, it's like it has this Ten of Wands vibe, doesn't it? But again, there is this element of having to, you know, maybe you will have to drop one of those things you're doing in order to make a decision. So it keeps the meaning remains the same, more or less. Then we have the Three of Pentacles. Maybe there are things that you need to be working on. It looks like there's work to be done. That's the idea or the message I'm picking up. Four of Pentacles. Here we see a completely different, you know, idea. I see duality. Not only because of this couple of suns, but also we have here, I don't know, which something that can be a couple of moons, a white one and a black one. And I have this feeling of a Seven of Pentacles, if you know what I mean, something that's growing. But still, there is attachment. Could be that as well. I mean, what they were thinking or what Carlota was thinking when she designed this deck. Then we have the Five of Pentacles. Interesting. I sense loneliness from that card. Six of Pentacles, yeah, we have that message about balance, for sure. Seven of Pentacles, yeah. Patience, you can definitely see that in that card. Eight of Pentacles, the work, work, work card. Oh, that's how I like to call it. Nine of Pentacles, luxurious. Look at me. I'm accomplished. I have everything I need, but I'm all by myself. Okay, that's the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, definitely. And the Ten of Pentacles to me here is saying something like, my work is done in here. I don't need to do anything anymore. I have as much stability as I can get. But you see, here we have a dragon being all by himself or herself. Okay, so again, the idea you get from the card is a bit different. Then we have the Page of Pentacles. Yeah, we sense this movement in this card. And this energy that comes with the pages, you know, because they represent younger people. Knight of Pentacles. See a unicorn in there. Queen of Pentacles. And the King of Pentacles. These two cards make me think about Mother Earth, Gaia. Yeah. And you see, we have a house here. I don't know why. There must be a reason behind that. And we have a lot of different cultures in here. So this must be, I don't know, it must be connected to something from a certain culture. I don't know, but there must be a reason behind it. But anyway, that vibe about that we have with earth signs, it's pretty well represented in there. Now let's see what else we have. Oh, okay, so here we have the Cups, Ace of Cups. Two of Cups. We don't actually see people, but we can guess or suppose that they are having breakfast and, you know, they are together. We can say also somebody wants to ask you out. If we pull that card, I don't know, that's just coming to mind. Three of Cups, celebration, yeah. Four of Cups, I sense indecisiveness from this card more than, you know, lack of motivation. Interesting. Five of Cups, I see this more as an Eight of Cups because I see movement. You know, in the Five of Cups, you know, the traditional one, we see someone there just, you know, crying over spilled milk, so to speak, but there's no movement. But here we do have that, or at least I'm sensing that. But anyway, we have that element of regret. Then we have, where is the six? The Six of Cups. Six of Cups. Yeah, we definitely see childhood and, you know, distant past memories. This must have been inspired in Alice in Wonderland for sure because of the rabbit we have in there. Seven of Cups, options. Eight of Cups. Okay, we have the Eight Cups in here. And I see somebody who has to make a decision in this case because we have a key here. Yeah, interesting. It adds more complexity, or it can add a different perspective to a reading. I love that. Nine of Cups. I have everything I need, but don't touch anything because it might you might break something. That's what I'm hearing as I'm seeing this card, okay? Because that's, you know, the wish fulfillment card. Ten of Cups. A feast. I don't know, it's like I have so much that now is my time to share it with you. That's the message I'm picking up from this one. Because we don't have any family in there. Page of Cups. Knight of Cups. You see, I thought about, I was about to say Knight of Swords because of, you know, this is, this is a unicorn. But then I saw the cup and I was like, okay, it's the Knight of Cups. I thought this was a sword, you know? But yeah, of course, it's the Knight of Cups. But that was the first thing I saw. Then we have the Queen of Cups, and she has a pet. She has a teddy bear in there, which is interesting because now you'll see how this little teddy bear we're having here, that's how I'm seeing it, okay? Turns into the King of Cups himself, which is pretty interesting. You can take that as how somebody's feelings are progressing. That's, you know, I'm telling you what's coming to mind as I see the cards. Then we have the Swords, Ace of Swords. Two of Swords, duality. Three of Swords, yeah. Your classic Three of Swords. With this burning fire. It's like somebody's hurt but still has feelings for the other person. That's, you know, what's coming to mind. Four of Swords here tells me like I need to rest. Even though there's still a lot of work to do, I need to rest. I don't care. Interesting. I mean, I'm telling you everything that's coming to mind as I see these cards. I mean, I have a lot of thoughts, which is amazing. So I believe this will give me great readings. Five of Swords. I can hurt you. That's what I'm watching you. I know a lot about you and I can hurt you. That's what I see with that card. Again, it translates into the same thing, which is conflict. Six of Swords. Yeah, somebody going to a, you know, calmer place. We see that movement. Makes me think about the Eight of Wands. Seven of Swords. Lies. Someone being deceitful. You can definitely sense that from this card. Eight of Swords. Yeah, somebody who's trapped. Who has a blindfold. The self-imposed trap, so to speak. That's what we're seeing here. Nine of Swords, pretty, you know, the classical Nine of Swords. Torment, sleepless nights. Ten of Swords, we have, you know, the heart from the Three of Swords, but with more swords in it. And yeah, it gives us this message of tongues of pain. There's like a virgin crying in there, you see. We have the Page of Swords, Knight of Swords. We see the movement here with the Knight of Swords, the Queen of Swords. She has a pet, which is a unicorn, you see. Off with their heads, I've just heard as I saw this image. She's really ruthless. I see this queen being ruthless, upright, and reversed because of the way she's being presented in here. Interesting. And no, the Knight of the King of Swords doesn't turn into a unicorn like happened with the King of Cups, who turned into a teddy bear. But here we have the King of Swords, and we have that his pet is like, I don't know what kind of animal this is. Looks like some sort of dragon. And interesting how they have a pet with them, an animal with them. Because normally you have like the Queen of Wands with the cat, you know? But we don't see that with the other kings and queens. I mean, not so clearly. Then we have the Ace of Wands. Pretty colorful. It talks to me about creativity, that's for sure. Two of Wands, options. Left or right, that's what I'm seeing. Three of Wands. Look at what I have accomplished. That's what I'm hearing as I see this. Four of Wands is like, to me here, yeah, I have a lot to celebrate, but I'm still alone. That's what I'm seeing from this card, okay? But yeah, you have that vibe of celebration. Five of Wands. A conflict in which people are pretending something that they are not. Because these are horses who pretend to be unicorns. That's what I'm seeing, okay? But anyway, we have that chaos in here with the Five of Wands. Six of Wands, a victory. Seven of Wands, a challenge. going through a very, very challenging situation. You see how she's having this really hard time just, you know, going through that place. Eight of Wands. Okay. So, I don't see any movement in here. Which is what you know, the Eight of Wands represents. So this can, you know, have a completely different interpretation. I love that. Nine of Wands. There is a potential danger in here. That's what I'm seeing. Because I see this as a volcano. So it's like something is about to explode. I don't know. That's what I'm sensing. And we have the Ten of Wands. Yeah. The classical image of somebody who is, you know, who has the world on his or her shoulders. Page of Wands, very colorful, very lively. Knight of Wands, there is movement in here, and he is, you know, willing to risk whatever it takes. You know, he's already fighting some sort of dragon. Oh, I love that one. Queen of Wands, look how colorful she is, and she has, you know, her black cat next to her. And finally, we have the King of Wands with a pet dragon. See? Pretty beautiful. So that's everything, guys, boys and girls, dear viewers and subscribers. I promised to make a short video. I couldn't, you know, deliver that. But anyway, this is everything I have. I hope you like this review. I hope you find it helpful. And of course, as I always tell you, see you next time. Of course, in this case, see you during my weekly readings. Goodbye.